Okay, since medyo marami nagtatanong, I decided to make a vlog that would answer the question, paano ba ako nakakuha ng scholarship para makapag-aral sa New Zealand? Game? First off, I can actually summarize this in just one word. Online. Kung bakit, I'll get back to that later. So who is my scholarship sponsor? Ang nag-sponsor ng scholarship ko ay ang MFAT, or the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade ng New Zealand. It's like the DFA of the Philippines. So why are they providing such scholarship? Well, it's a program that they have in partnership with developing countries. So they sponsor scholars to study in New Zealand, so afterwards, they can use what they've learned to contribute to the improvement of their home country. What is my scholarship called? It's called New Zealand Scholarships. That is the umbrella program. For the Philippines, we're under the New Zealand ASEAN Scholarships, or as we call it amongst ourselves, NZAS. So what does the scholarship cover? Full tuition fees and all expenses required by the university. All fees associated with processing your travel to New Zealand, such as IELTS fee, visa medical, stipend or allowance. For how much, you can check it on their website. But I'd say it's pretty generous. I mean, it's not a lot, pero hindi ka rin naman magugutom. With proper money management, kaya pa rin naman makapag-ipon, which you can use to travel, or maipadala sa family back home. Or both. Also, allow din naman ng mga international students to work part-time up to 20 hours per week, which could allow you to save more. There's also the establishment allowance, which you can use to set yourself up when you arrive, and reintegration allowance when you go back to the Philippines. Other things as well as deemed necessary, like proofreading or tutoring allowance, or some reimbursements here and there. Basically, you won't really have to pay a single cent. Okay, ito na. These two are probably what you'd be most interested with. How to apply? Like I said earlier, you just apply online. Check out their website, the link is in the description. So there will be quite a lengthy application form, lots of essays to write. What I can advise you is that, make sure you know why you want to study in New Zealand, why you're choosing that university, you know what program you want to apply to, you know why you want that program, or how it could be of help to your home country or the Philippines. So after you submit the application form, there's gonna be a psychometric exam and an interview. Then that's it. Fingers crossed ka na after nun, hoping na makapasok ka. Disclaimer lang, that was the process during my time, which was 2 years ago. I'm not sure if binago na nila, but with how things are, I'm pretty sure it'll still be mostly online. Anyway, when you get accepted, then you can start applying to your preferred university. So while doing so, you can be secure that your study will be fully funded by a scholarship. Now this is very important. Application intakes begin in February 1 and ends, or the deadline is on February 28, every year. So if you want to apply this coming February, you can start creating your personal account na on their website and start collating the requirements now. Now that's the second thing you'd be most interested with. What are the requirements? Since medyo matagal na yung sa akin, it's a bit hazy to me. Anyway, you can check naman everything on their website. But primarily, you will need an IELTS. It's an International English Proficiency exam that you need to take. The exam is divided into 4 bands. Reading, listening, speaking, writing. And from what I remember, your overall score should be at least 6, with no band less than 6. Back then, IELTS exam costed around 10k, which you can reimburse naman when you get accepted in the scholarship. You need your TOR, or your official transcript of records in college. Now, eligibility-wise, you need to have worked in the Philippines for at least 2 years. Although I think now, 1 year na lang. Again, that was during my time, so better to check the full details in their website. And then of course, once you get in, you need the official acceptance letter from the university and all the visa stuff sorted out. Okay, so what's the catch? You might find it a bit hard to believe. Now all that, wala kang babayaran. Even the process and the requirements are not that grueling. So this is the main catch. After your study, you have to go back to the Philippines and stay there for at least 2 years. Pwede ka pa rin naman mag-travel abroad within that 2 years, but you can't work or live overseas. It's really important that you know this simula pa lang, because some might be aiming for studying in New Zealand and then staying in New Zealand afterwards. That isn't the case with this scholarship. So if you're someone who happens to found some sense of comfort and happiness in New Zealand during your stay there, then you have to know that a time will come when you need to leave and go back to the Philippines. Okay, just a bonus. What other scholarships are there? Well, actually, it depends sa country na gusto mong puntahan. As far as I know, these are the ones that tinignan ko noon. New Zealand Scholarships by MFAT. Australian Awards, or the counterpart-ish of my scholarship. ADB-JSP, or the Asian Development Bank Japan Scholarship Program. Mumbuka Gakusho, or MEXT for Japan. Erasmus Mundus for European countries. Now I'm sure marami pang iba out there. Here's the key, search online. That's just what I did. No one told me about this. I had no connections. One day I just started searching online and kept going. There are lots of scholarships out there. Many people were surprised when I got this scholarship. but I was more surprised that not that many people applied or have been applying. As you see, it's doable, feasible, available, accessible. You just need to allot the right amount of time and effort, and what you get in return will be really rewarding. So how is life there? Well, it's different. The weather and standard of living and all, but I can't deny that it's good. Transportation system is good. The payment scheme in almost everything is cashless. It's culturally diverse. You will get to meet a lot of people from all over the world. At the same time, marami pa ring Pinoy. There are lots of picturesque travel destinations, but most importantly, when you go there to study, your number one priority will be to study. And that is what my next vlog is going to be about. How different is a New Zealand university versus a Philippine university in terms of difficulty level? So thank you sa panonood. Remember, this is a vlog. So for more credible source, you gotta do your own research. Check out their website, search online. But I hope what I shared was helpful, or at least it gave you an idea, and you wouldn't need to start from scratch. So, peace!